Good afternoon to the August gathering of these young and ignited minds. I am Sachin Bahmba and I am from space. I am actually not come from another planet to give you this talk. I am not even an astronaut who has traveled to space. I wish to do that sometime in my life. I am not an astrologer who can tell you what is going to happen in your life. I am an astronomer. I am a scientist who studies about planets, stars, galaxies, and so on and so forth. And a famous philosopher, Plato, once said, astronomy compels you to look up. You can't see that, but astronomy compels you to look up. And it simply takes you from one world to another. And that is so true in my life. I never thought that I am going to do what I do today. But then there are two incidents, remarkable incidents, then changed my life forever. The first one was being naughty. I simply stole, you know, hand glass of my grandfather and made my first telescope when I was around 12 years of age. The telescope was fine. I used to sort of peep into the windows of other houses till one day at night, I suddenly pointed it towards the moon. And I was not expecting what I saw. It was an amazing, spectacular view. And I tell you, of you who have not seen moon yet through a telescope, find someone or contact me or my organization. We'll show you the moon. It is going to change your life forever. And that is what happened with me. I saw that there were craters on the moon. I saw that telescope was able to resolve something which I cannot ever imagine, I cannot ever expect. And then I suddenly realized that my teacher taught me about microscope and telescope in class 6th. I'm sure all of you have also read about telescope and microscope in class 6th. And by the time you come to class 10th, there is a microscope in your lab. You do an experiment, but the telescope is missing. And somehow, very systematically, telescope has been taken out of the Indian education system. But even after realizing this, and after having the urge to find a better telescope, which I tell you was very difficult to find in Delhi in those days. So I went around. It took me 3 years, although during that time I made my 1-2 more series 1, series 2 telescopes. But to find a professional telescope, it took me 3 years when finally I reached Nehru Planetarium and got hold of the first professional telescope. And that telescope again opened up a new world for me. I was able to see galaxies. I was able to see, you know, beautiful wonders of the universe. But still, I never thought that I will become a science popularizer and run an organization. So I run an organization called Space, which is into astronomy and space science education, and also the tourism associated to astronomy and space science. Why did we run an organization? I could have been an astronomer because this is what ultimately made me so passionate about. But we started to run an organization just to create jobs for people. Because I realized that if I am an astronomer, I'll sit in a lab, work on something, come out with a theory, maybe do a discovery, and nothing is going to change the lives of the common man. We wanted common man to be involved into science propagation and popularization. And that is why we started this organization. My first realization of that telescope was missing from the Indian education system did not make me think about starting this organization, but it was the second incident. A very interesting incident that happened in Bhind. Does any of you know where is Bhind and Murena? It is in MP. And does any of you know that why is it famous for? It is very notorious for dacoits. Phulan Devi and any dacoit that you can think of used to be in the ravines of Chambal of that area. I am talking about 1995. It was the total solar eclipse of 1995 on the day of Diwali, on 30th of October, I think, on that day. We had gone along with the team of Nehru Planetarium under the leadership of Dr. Nirupama Raghavan. We set up our equipment in Bhind because one of our amateur astronomer was from Bhind and he knew the locals around. And he took us there. We set up our equipment on a roof of a government school. And we were sitting there, two of us were sitting there just taking care of our equipment. And I'll tell you something about Bhind. if I see around, let's say 70 people moving around in wind, 50 would be carrying a gun, a dunali. And you know, everybody carries a gun there, and at night, 4 or 5 along with their guns came and started finding spots for themselves. We said, I interrupted and said that you cannot be on this roof. They said, no, we will be here because we want to see the eclipse from the place where you have set up your experiments, because we know this is the best place to see the experiment, see the eclipse. I said, no, it is fine. You can see eclipse from anywhere. But they did not agree with me, and I was a young boy and, you know, also strong at that point of time. So I simply raised my voice, and as soon as I raised my voice, he took out his gun and put it on my chest. So it was going on, and then suddenly somebody was intelligent enough. He sent it to our director, Dr. Nirupama Raghavan, who is also my mentor. And she was told that this was going on the roof, and she came back running. And then she explained those two guys coolly that, you know, you don't have to worry about. We will make you see the eclipse. And I'll send someone with you who will, you know, show you the eclipse properly as it has to be seen. At that time, the totality was for 52 seconds. And 52 seconds means that the moon was going to cover the disk of the sun for 52 seconds. Now let me tell you, you can only safely watch the eclipse when it is totality. That means the moon has fully covered the photosphere of the sun. And she told that we'll send someone, and I don't know how that happened, but finally I was the one who had to go with them. So they took me to the banks of Chambal, and around 150 people came along. Out of that again 70-80 guns, and everybody stood in front of me. Now I had to make them see the totality of eclipse for 52 seconds, and that too naked eye. And the drill was simple. I explained them, and I did not have a mic. So there were around 70-80 people, 150 people in front of me. I was explaining that I will count, I'll say look up, and all of you will look up. I'll count to 52, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then say look down, and you will all have to look down. So I told them, you can only see through the sun while it is fully covered by the disk of the moon. But then I did not have eclipse gear, so I could not make them practice towards the sun. So I made everyone turn around, and I started my practice. The front row of 3 or 4 people, 30-40 people, knew what I was saying. The back row did not know what was happening. So while I made everyone see in the other direction where the sun was, then again somebody from the back said, "Oh, befu banta bhai." And that was again, I said, who is going to help me now? And at that moment, the same guy who had kept the gun on my chest became a science popularizer. I could see the transformation that science has done to him. And that was mesmerizing to me. I was just dumbstruck. I just saw that he jumped out, he became a science popularizer, and he explained those people who were shouting at back, "Sahi karwa raha hai." And he explained the process to them now. And he became my assistant, and we both made people observe that eclipse. And that is how I understood the importance and the impact of popularizing science among people. That is when we decided that this is what I want to do. And we came back. So this is the second point, which, you know, you cannot observe naked eye. So we came back and we started an NGO, because we thought that we were doing philanthropy, and it is actually philanthropy, and we thought, you know, we will gather money from somewhere, find money, and do whatever projects we want to do with the students of school, because we now know that they do not have access to telescopes, and the teachers are not equipped enough to teach astronomy, although chapters start from class 2nd onwards till class 11th. So we thought we'll go to schools, and we started an NGO called Science Popularization Association of Communicators and Educators. So the acronym SPACE, and looked for money, but no one knew us. Whatever was our story, no one knew us. No one gave us money. We simply had whatever we had in our pockets, we contributed and did few projects. And then finally we realized that if we seriously want to do this, we'll have to do something more. We'll have to generate money for ourselves. So we opened up the first company, which is the education company of the group, and we created a space club. I do not know if the students sitting in this room, any of you belongs to the space club, but there are many students in MIT who have been part of our club. So the club was a wonderful mixture of the exposure of science. It had a night observation, an evening observation, an exposure to telescope, astrophotography. So it was a wonderful mix to ignite somebody's mind to start observing the nature and derive science and numbers out of it. It is one thing that you are told that the earth is round. It is another thing that I make you measure the circumference of the earth using a simple pen. So once you do science hands on, your mind is on and you understand more science. So we started a club. In 2003, we offered our club to few schools. I need to thank the principals of the schools of Delhi. They helped us, they understood the importance of the concept, and the club was opened in mere 12 schools of Delhi. But as soon as we started working, these students, first we taught them few skills and then they inspired us. You know, they gave so much response to the skills that we taught that we had to start international projects with them. And the very first project that we did was measuring actually the distance between the sun and the earth, and 6th, 7th, 8th class students actually measured that distance using the Venus transit in 2004. 25,000 students all over India participated with us. Dr. Nirupama Raghavan headed that project and it was a huge success, mentioned in almost all international papers. As the years passed by, more and more students and schools joined it and it took the shape of a company. But then came the next problem. Whatever equipment we needed, whatever educational needs we needed, we did not find a company that was making it. So I had to start another company, which is the manufacturing company. And if you see here, that's called Namon Astrotech. So we create our own games, our own educational aids, our own filters to do that study of astronomy and things. And so the space group started to begin and take shape. And things went on, and this education and the more and more students joining in finally have culminated into something wonderful. I have huge pride to tell you that now students of 6th, 7th and 8th discover new asteroids with us. In fact, two of the students of MIT, Parachi and Kanak, they were the discoverers last year. I also feel pride to tell you that last year the number of asteroids discovered by Indian students alone was much more than the asteroid discovered by rest of the students of the world all around. So this is the impact of astronomy on these young kids. And when this was going on, while this company was being formed, we had already created jobs in science popularization. So it was not astronomy which was important. It was, what was important was that students who wanted to be science popularizers now have a company to join and pursue what they really want to do. And I also want to tell you, we are now the largest non-government, non-funded organization of the world which has created these many jobs in the field of science popularization. Since the purpose was creating jobs, I also identified one more opportunity, and that was astro-tourism. It was natural for people to travel at locations. You know, people want to travel to see meteor showers. It's a wonderful show that universe puts up for us. They want to travel to watch eclipses. I was myself on August 21 in US covering the eclipse of August 21. And so we identified the opportunity. And then a wonderful opportunity struck us on 2009 when it was the greatest eclipse of India, happening in India. And the next eclipse is going to happen 105 years. So 2009 was the final eclipse. We planned ahead. We talked to the government of Gujarat. Our Prime Minister now was then CM of Gujarat. We also talked to the PM of Bihar, because the totality line was starting from Gujarat and crossing through Bihar. And Bihar responded first, because Mr. Nitish Kumar himself is an engineer. So he responded first, and we decided that we'll go to Bihar and do a recce and find the spot. When we went to Bihar, we found Taregana. The name struck me Why Taregana? So I asked the localite, why do you call it Taregana? He said that this is the place where Aryabhatta counted the stars. So in 2009, we decided, first we were thinking of doing our observation from Jahanabad, but then we decided we'll do it from Taregana. And we did our observation from Taregana. And do you know how many people attended that observation? It is the largest ever organized public watch for eclipse by any organization in the world. 1,84,000 people attended that watch that we organized. So it was the start of astrotourism in India. It immediately struck to the chief minister. He opened up a minister and told him that, you know, we should start a department of astrotourism. I was called and I was told that the place where actually Aryabhatta did his observation near the Som Nadi, he gave me a good piece of land to develop a concept there. But then political turmoil happened and he obviously had to step down. So I also stepped down, left going to Bihar. But then that need of having a spot where we could provide employment to people and where the people other than school students could come and enjoy the wonders of astronomy, we felt that need very strongly. So we have developed the first astroport, which is the Astronomy and Space Experience Retreat. It is the first retreat of the world near Alwar, and you are all welcome to come someday there, make rockets, fly them, become a child again, you know, control a camera or a telescope that is right there in America from Astroport. So it's a wonderful facility. It is not only a facility of astronomy, but has become a hub of socio-economic development. And so this is Astroport. It's a wonderful sky there. And it is acting as a hub of socio-economic development because other than providing the job, the students nearby, the village nearby is involved into the activity and research of basic astronomy. They give reports every day, what kind of cloud cover is there, what is the visibility of the site, and the propagation of science is so interesting that is happening at Astroport. So we are now thinking of opening up astroports all over India, and I think around 1500 to 2000 people will be employed in these astroports in the next 3 years. Space is doing wonderful work, and few of the achievements that I want to talk to you about is in 2009, as I said, that we planned a huge sort of paraphernalia to launch astrotourism. In 2009, we also organized the first passenger flight that chased eclipse, and it was the first flight of India. In 2010, again, we became the organization who actually chased the eclipse from land, water, and air, and again, it was a record that was set by space. As far as our students are concerned, they are finding admission in prime universities. They are working with us during eclipses, becoming scientists, and then going to universities like Stanford and Cambridge and wonderful universities like MIT, and doing good work in science. Now, while this is all happening and we are inspiring kids, we are also creating a lot of jobs for people. And I invite the students here that I am a single man doing this, who started very humbly and has been able to provide jobs to hundreds and hundreds of people in India. I now implore the youth of today to come forward, work with us. Astronomy is just not a science, but it is something that can change the society forever. Let's work together. And all this has been done because the 16-year-old boy who made his own telescope was not able to find a telescope in Delhi anywhere. So now I have taken this mission that every child should have his own telescope, should have his own wings, and should be working for us. In the end, my message for all of you would be not my own message, but the message of our astronaut Sunita Williams. Space is your future. Get involved. Thank you. Thank you very much.